us up. This is Blaise, the movie fan, and about a week ago with a poll asking what movie I should review today. Let's take a look at the results of that poll, shall we?
Oh shit! Okay, you guys asked for it and you guys score it. Today I will be reviewing South Park Bigger, Longer and Uncut. And for those who voted for something else, don't worry, I will be getting into those movies eventually. It most likely will take fucking years. But I will reach all of those movies eventually, I promise.
So yeah, without further ado, let's begin. Now South Park needs no introduction, obviously. Now before I start reviewing South Park Bigger, Longer and Uncut, I'm gonna give you a bit of a backstory. There are many movies from the 2000s that I watched during my teenage years and early adulthood. This is not one of those movies. I didn't watch the movie when it was new. But you know why? Because I fucking hated South Park back then. As a matter of fact, I didn't start liking the show until 2013. Before then, I hated it. And because of that, I obviously didn't watch the fucking movie. But I did watch it sometime after that. But I never got around to reviewing it until now. Also, here's some interesting trivia for you. The fact that this movie has the word fuck throughout a lot of it, totally uncensored, was a big deal back then. That is why the movie is called South Park Bigger, Longer and Uncut. I mean sure, when you watch any South Park episode now on the internet, whether it been the original seasons or the later seasons, you can watch all the episodes with the word fuck totally uncensored. But it wasn't like that back then. You could only watch this show with the word completely censored. Hell, even the DVDs you could collect back then had the word fuck censored. So yeah, being able to hear that uncensored was a big deal back then. Sure, overall it was nothing new to hear that word in R-rated movies, but it was a big deal to watch something related to South Park uncensored. Alright, with that all out of the way, let's talk about the movie. One of the kids in South Park go watch an animated movie. And Sheila is not happy about that at all. In fact, she wants action to be taken against the people who made the movie. Speaking of that, I'm going to start talking about Sheila Brovowski, played by Mary Kay Bergman. Now she's a cunt, that goes without saying. An evil fucking cunt. She's so fucking sensitive to swear words that she's even willing to start a fucking war in order to eliminate swear words completely. And she also convinces people that the makers of that R-rated movie are fucking dangerous. Does this sound familiar? Yeah, it does. This is exactly how people who are for censorship act like today. Which means that this movie is as relevant now as it was back then. Now then, the next character I'm going to talk about is Eric Hartman, played by Trey Parker. Now he is my least favorite character of the show itself, and I usually don't like him. But in this movie, he is actually someone worth rooting for. He makes an entire fucking song where he is insulting Sheila. And oh boy, it was satisfying as hell. Hearing her insulted in that song was fucking awesome and it was also spot on. And there was also something forced in his brain so that every time he swears, he gets fucking shocked. And I felt sorry for him, I really did. I'm not gonna show itself, he never really did anything wrong in this movie. In fact, he was right. Sheila really is a cunt. The third and final character of the movie that I want to talk about is Karl Borowski, played by Matt Stone. Just like in the show, he's the fucking smartest one out of the group. In fact, he's the one who wants to save the makers of that R-rated movie from a terrible thing that's gonna happen to them. Now then, what I appreciate about this movie is its anti-censorship message. And it's an important message now, especially so a lot of people have to deal with deplatforming on places like Facebook, Twitter and so on. That really fucking sucks. Censorship is never the answer. Oh, and I also noticed something interesting about this movie. It's extremely fucking easy to follow even if you aren't familiar with the show. You don't need to watch the show in order to understand what the hell is going on in this movie. Which is very fucking nice. Because most movies based on TV shows aren't like that at all. And I'm only referring to the ones that have the same fucking crew as the TV show. Of course I'm only talking about animated movies based on TV shows here. With live action I don't fucking know, so I don't watch a lot of live action shows. Anyway, it's time for my overall thoughts. Although this isn't one of my favorite movies of all time, nor is it one of my favorite animated movies, it is definitely one of my favorite movies of all time based on a TV show that had the fucking crew behind that show. Hold on, what the hell am I saying? It is my absolute favorite, and for that I'm of course going to give it a rating 2 thumbs up. You have reached the end of the video, thank you for watching, have a great day.